Welcome, one and all, back to...
Well, let's play Earthbound.
Alright, last episode, we returned from Berlin Park after we got tipped that Paula has been kidnapped by some strange fat guy, apparently. Gee, I wonder who that is. Anyway, this episode, well, we're gonna be heading out to Peace Plus Valley, but not before visiting our good pal, Apple Kid. Alright. Actually, screw you, I'm taking this in the trash can. Working machine. Alright, we're gonna wanna keep this flary. We can't do anything with this right. Wait, we can't do anything with this right now, but trust me, it's worth all we got to. Well, I sort of neglected doing my housework. That's a bit of a pig side, but anyway, I'm up a kid. I'm taking the mask from awesome. Wow. Dude, I kinda feel bad for you. You don't even have a restroom. Just a bench and a mess of tools and stuff and a bookshelf, and that's it. Yeah, I do have something here I can give you. Here! Have a teddy bear! okay, I'm sorry. I had to. Blah blah blah. Yes, I'm stinky, starving, and I'm having my fun, so let's get my hamburger. Alright, now, as you may have noticed, I've taken some money out of the ATM machine. We need $200 exactly, so yeah, I may have overshot that, but whatever. And now the mouse is gonna block our radius feature. Get out of the way, man! Not someone asking me a name yet. How about Bob? Yeah, I think Bob suits you. Alright, return. He'll give us... Yay! Bob gave us the receiver phone! I don't know what it is with me just giving these names to random things. Oh, must be in the right. This is a weird thing of mine. Anyway, got the receiver phone. Oh, wait a minute. I'm getting any more money, aren't I? No, I just want to show this off a book. Greetings, I'm Orange Kid Inventor. Have you heard of me? I'm a bit embarrassed about my reputation, okay. He's also been an inventor, running short of cash. So, how much are you asking for? Sure. I'll be right back. Don't these guys kind of remind you of the Mario Brothers? I'm not about this one kid inventor. No, not the Apple kid. Apple Airhead. Talking about the incredibly hot orange kid. That stupid sloppy Apple kid always asks me something. He's the inventor. He should invent something for himself. The Apple Kid apparently has gotten some slack over the course of his inventing. Anyway, Orange Kid, I'm back with your money! Alright, yes. Alright. Here's your cash. This report should have a tremendous impact on all mankind. Let me give you my new super orange machine! The Superma. Okay, I don't know how this would do anything in regards to spreading peace on Earth, but okay. There's a description for this. Which guy's in my... The whole name is Super Orange Machine. The Superma sang the song, Ode to Orange Kid. As soon as it finished, the machine broke down. So yeah, it's useless, I just wanted to show it off. Anyway, before I head out, I'm gonna head here. It'll sell pizza here, only deliver it, right? So, yeah. We can now order pizza! Just by... Well... going in there, I guess. Alright, it's... I don't tend to use it all that much, but, yeah, ordering pieces every now and then. Oh, magic butterfly, musket. There is actually something pretty funny with a magic butterfly that I do intend to show later. It does require the bike, though. And I've actually made a Miiverse post about this, but I won't get into that right now. So, just go through the tunnel here. Yeah, that's... nice. Mobile Sprouts. Oh my god, these things suck. These guys got peas and madness, and they, scatter some seeds around, which is basically calling for help. And you know how much I love enemies that call for help. I'm in a Miiverse complaining about this. I'm not here talking about Miiverse. What do you got? Hum-dee-dum-dum-dum. I'm hunting for mushrooms, gonna collect a ton. Yes, have fun collecting mushrooms. You know, if you get 1 second in your head, go to the hospital. Alright, and speaking of, little UFO. Where did I say, ugh? Because I don't know where it is with these guys, but these guys have a tendency to actually capture. As soon as I say that, I one-shot it. Of course, it was a smashing attack, but hey, whatever. Okay, unfortunately, we're just not, so we have to move the long way around. Alright, so just here and get away from the UFO. I don't like you, I don't want to deal with you, and we can't progress any further because of the sand statue in the ring. For some weird reason, the physical shape iron statue is walking past, so we have to go back to the he has to go back to baby camp. And even if you know about this in advance, he has to go up to the statue and check it. Phone call interruption. Hello, this is Applekit. I just finished work on this great invention. Get here as fast as you can. This is so cool. See you soon. Okay. I guess we should go ahead and check out this awesome new invention! I hope it's awesome as he says it is. I mean, it's been $200. But then again, we did spend $200 on points in... yeah, that ended up being a sham. So, you know what? We're gonna go ahead and ride a bicycle there. Because rocking's for chumps. Haha! Alright, what do you have to say? Yes, we are, it's pretty genius, he's in Bergen Park, looking for a site. I know, I get. Yeah, wow, even the orange kid isn't like Alpha Kid. Ooh, we got a new enemy here. Unassuming local guy. I know, you just. Looks kind of plain and ordinary to me. Alright. This guy can basically drop one of the most useless items ever, the ruler. At least as far as I know, that it's absolutely useless, except for, like, one thing. That's not what I'm right now. It's just, if I can drop it. I'm feeling really out of it because I'm working all night. The pencil eraser is right. Wow, it's not a convenience. I mean, after all, we do need to get us an iron-shaped pencil, or pencil-shaped iron statue, or whatever. You know, just fight him. We should just go to, just go to a store that sells nothing but pencils and just use a pencil eraser and just get rid of the entire stock just to be good at that. Don't tell me. that's what I think it is. There's... I don't know if I mentioned that already. Posted note on screen if I have. But this is a really annoying mechanic called homesickness. Basically what it does is, it's a really annoying status infection that only Ness can get. It'll cause Ness to sometimes miss the attacks. He'll sometimes do nothing at all. And so, like, Ness caught a whiff of his tank and started craving it, and I do nothing. Here it is. Alright. It looks like Ness is eating the magic butterfly. I don't know, I always find that funny. Meanwhile, on standby, Ness got a mushroom. Okay, this is something that I should address. If you have gone a while playing this game, your dad will call you. You've been out there for a long time now. Maybe not my business. Don't you think it'd be good if you take a break?
No!
I see. But it doesn't make me happy. Then I understand your point of the fate of the world being at stake. Okay, I actually have something funny to say about that. But... No, actually, I'm gonna go about... Now. I've had that come up before. Where Dad called at the end of the game after the final boss. Like, no joke. I even have the Miiverse post up on screen for it. Oh! Something I completely forgot about. Sorry this is like, jump cut. Sorry if I mean jump cut happy here, but this is something I completely neglected. It's gonna draw some money here. Just cause I can, cause why not? It's my money. I can draw if I want to. Alright. When I say it would be $50, so we're gonna wanna do that real quick. Ness, Paula. I am Paula. Can you hear me calling you? Help! Come and help me. I don't know where I am. I can hear water running in the distance. Ness, please help me. Now, I've gone through countless playthroughs where I didn't trigger that. Alright, now if you go over here, talk to this guy. What? So what? Huh? Pardon? Geez. Hmm? You're annoying. Dang me. Yeah. Ahaha. Hey, you. There it is, pal. Ahaha. It's so hot today. It rocks. Is it cold today? Oh ho ho, see ya. Here, get yourself a juice or something. Ka-ching! You get $50, so basically you stay at the hotel for free. You can only do this once though, so be careful. Alright. Here this morning is too. The brave looking hero named Ness broke up the sharks and has left one at. Reports said that the mayor has proven to be false. Yep, this is kind of what I was saying last time, you know, like the mayor. Anyway, it's time to go. Paula, where are you? Is that for your yummy piece of pie? I'd be embarrassed about having a father like that. I would just shout down public. Alright, and we're back at Peaceful's Valley. Now, on the way back to the, Iron-shaped pencil statue, I should take the time to mention that one enemy that we didn't encounter in, Tucson, and that's the Cranky Lady. Isn't really all that special. I believe the really drop the index trap. Which I believe is, I'm used to it on damage enemies. I could be wrong on that though. I've never used a handbag strap myself, nor did I ever bother to check it, so yeah, I'm kind of in the dark with that. And go away, UFOs! Okay, I can live with the most part. Yay, go teddy bear! That's my punching bag. Did I just seriously refer to a teddy bear as a punching bag? Luckily, we have something to do with that. Bye bye. Alright. Well, since we're at 25 minutes on my end, can I call this video quits? You know, I don't know how much footage is gonna be in the final cut. Can I? Nah, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna be that mean. To me, it's a foes. But for some reason. I guess coming here is just a Kodiak moment, I guess. For whatever reason. And granted, there's like a mini little waterfall there. But other than that, I don't see what's so special about this area. Territorial look. I'll tell the stats on screen right now, because I don't want to fight those things. Alright, the territorial oak. Oh my god, those things are strong. And if you kill them, they will explode. And yes, this game has a business glitch. If you kill them at low health, and this explosion kills you, yeah, that triggers a win-lose glitch that can potentially crash the game. It sucks. So, anyways, like that, I'm gonna avoid them like the plague. Yes. Straight up. Okay. I believe this is where you can open this present from down here. I want to say it's possible. Maybe check it out somehow. Nah, I don't think we can, unfortunately. We're in racing time here. Oh, a new enemy! Oh my god, do we get to fight the diamond? No! It's a spinning robo. Spinning robos do that where they have shield alpha. Which is annoying. It can also cause a cold. Which does look cool. As soon as I say it, of course. Cold enemies will obviously cure the cold, but so is healing alpha, which is why I did a bit of the cold remedy in the last episode. Speaking of, I'm not gonna do that. Yeah, I just find using healing alpha to be so much better than just bugging around the cold remedy. Okay, in this chest, look out soul! I'm gonna go and use that straight away. Look out, soul, as it implies, it raises luck, which is not bad. Okay, let's go around you guys. Alright, and what do you guys say? I wonder who made this bridge impassable. Why would someone do this? Crud. Yeah, it kinda makes things a little inconvenient, but hey. An idiot, right? Now, I believe there's a couple of items along here I didn't want to pick up. Let's see, the one, I don't believe is anything too special. Oh, never mind. It's a bomb. It's a bomb? Oh my god, he's got a bomb! And why did I find that? I don't know. Maybe it's just like wasting time. Could be, huh? But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and, yeah, the croissant is better, I'll just use burger. Cause the croissant is a better item than it is. Does it? Oh my god. Wow! Ready to be a jerk, team. Faked me out into thinking I got into a battle with a turtle. Yeah. Ready to be a jerk. Actually, I had me kind of worried there. Oh, look, a croissant! Yay! It's so worthwhile when there's another item around here that I need a lot more. Alright, up here. There's no church hello, because if we jump around here. Oh, thank god. A hard hat! Alright. Is it a... Alright. Put that in the ring. Maybe we get a solid 9 points in my defense on that. Because that's an array. Okay, awesome. Alright, so... Around here, I believe that's the, exact same... area where, Paula tell us by telephone. Like, there is even that, Ralph on the background as well, so... Oh, goal sake, I just wanna kill you! Just to be a jerk! Ha 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 ha! Well, the mechanic just instantly killing in me when I'm running into them. Kinda wish more of these did that. You're certainly stronger than you were running around with it. Have you ever suddenly gotten your one message? When you made it begin me? That surefire proves that you've become stronger. Yes! You got a point there, Mr. Mole. Why should we waste our time finding really weak enemies? Okay. Now, this right here. I like this quite a bit. I trust you. Yeah. Well, I mean, also... yeah, so much for re-trust you. My inventory's full, wonderful. Hold on a sec, I'm gonna clear my inventory real quick. Alright. So for now, you shall take the bicycle. I want to ride my bicycle. Okay, I'm not gonna charge you with my singing. Alright, and we don't need the pencil eraser for now. So we're just gonna throw that away. So much for trusting us. Alright. Now, I like this. We can take an item without paying. Something of it. Oh my god, Skype. Alright, there we go. I won't be bothered by Skype. Alright. See, take another fresh egg. So, in other words, yay, thievery! Who'd have thought thievery was possible? I got this guy now. He will attack you. So this is for attacking us, he attacked us because we're thieving, and because he attacked us for thieving, I'm gonna attack him. Yeah, that's solid reasoning right there. Got me a pretty decent level up. Alright, now the reason I got those fresh eggs is that after a while they will hatch into chicks and chickens. And you can actually sell those at a pretty good price, but anyway, that aside, insane cultist! These guys are kind of weak enemies, but these guys fall into the annoying enemy category as they can call for help. It's kind of surprised it didn't... No, I shouldn't say anything. So, I'm probably gonna grind out these guys a little bit off screen. And, I think we've done this for this episode, right? So, now that we arrived at this depressing looking place, it's actually Happy Happy Village. Not so much of this being happy, especially with the kind of music that's playing, that should be kind of an indicator. Next time on Let's Play Earthbound, we'll be heading to that cottage we're seeing in an attempt to rescue Paula. So, if you like this, be sure to like, favorite, comment, and subscribe! Be sure to check out Megastone Edge for 3DS LPs as well as Ace Attorney Online cases, alright? I'll see you guys later!